researchers argue that productivity can be achieved by improving the quality and implementing both the just-in-time and lean accounting approach. And this question worth 6 marks. So how would you answer that? Don't tell me not a clue. So I said before, please don't leave anything blank. We covered all the topic. I'm 100% sure you know, you at least understand. If I ask you what the quality is all about, even if you give you, if you give me a sentence, that's it. All I really need you to know is just, you don't have a clue what is the link between these four, productivity, lean, just in time, you don't have a clue. Okay, I agree with you that some of you, they don't know what does it mean or what is the link. But even if you just try to split that and saying, for example, quality means producing a defective-free product. A high quality means a defective-free product. Lean accounting means, or lean manufacturing means producing the right product with the right quantity, with the right quality at the time needed, so on. And just in time means producing, we always under just in time looking for zero inventory policy or this manufacturing cell layout that leads to efficiency and productivity. You can find the answer. Even if you didn't find the proper link between each one of them, even listing each one, you will pick up that definitely there is a link between just in time and lean accounting. Between just in time, between lean accounting and the quality. Because even one of the lean dimension producing a high quality product. Okay? Question, the third question is about quality. This topic, we covered this topic in week 2 under quality, and we spent time how to prepare the quality cost report, and we agreed that the quality cost report, you have 4 categories, right? What are these categories? Prevention, appraisal, internal failure, external failure. So we have 4 categories, right? So I will give you the trick here, because once you prepared a proper quality cost report, you will be able to comment on that. You have here sales, right? Can you count how many items here? 8. And how many categories we have under the quality cost report? 4. So that means basically I gave you 2 items with each category. So when you prepare the quality cost report and you find yourself put 3 items under 1 category, that there is something wrong here. Just go and have a wee look and revise. If you put 1 item under 1 category, that means something happened. So that means with a something like that, you have 2 under each category. And you will never ever find surprises. So once you go over the lecture notes, once you go over the tutorial questions, once you go over the past papers, you will find identical items. So you will not find, how can I, this item, how can I allocate this item, or where I can put this item, under which category? You will not find this. What I found from previous experience, most of the students, something like 90% of the students, get the prevention and the external failure absolutely correct. So always the confusion between the appraisal and the internal failure. So when you study, please focus on these 2. Because prevention is always very easy, stuff training and stuff, and external failure is very easy. But the always 2 categories that confusing students are appraisal and the internal failure. So focus more on them, on these 2 categories, please. And then prepare a quality cost report. If you do the allocation, sorry, the preparing a quality cost report with a percentage related to sales, this will give you 10 marks straight away. Once you just do the calculation, putting the category it under each one of them, I will just show you here. Here is question number 2. Sorry, number 3. Here is 2 years, we have sales. You just put the sales here, and this is the categories, prevention, appraisal, internal, and external. And you just list them, adding them, know how to do. Do you know how to do the percentage of sales? So you just take the figure and relate it this to sales, and you'll get all of that. Once you finish with this, you can secure 10 marks out 10 marks for this sub question. And then the second part is prepare a quality cost report. To prepare a quality cost report, I think I've mentioned this in class as well, and in the tutorials and everything, that you have to prepare a distribution of the quality cost report, even if I didn't mention. Because once you prepare that, you secure at least 4 marks or something, and this will help you in preparing a proper comment on the quality cost report. Will help you preparing that. Do you want me to go over this? No comment, that means yes or no. Yes? Okay, here, with the quality, these figures are from the questions, right? So for quality training, we have 860. If you divide the 860 by the 20,000 sales figure, you will get this percentage. Okay? And the same for everything. Distribution of the quality cost report is the total prevention cost. For example, I'm talking here about the total prevention cost in 2015. This is the total prevention cost, okay? We are related this to the total quality cost in the same year. Nothing to do with sales. When we prepare the distribution of the quality cost report, it's nothing to do with sales. We are linking the each category to the total quality cost. Okay? And then, based on this column, sorry, on this one, and this one, you will be able to provide a fantastic comment on the quality report. So what you are going to say? You are going to say, you start by saying that the total quality cost for the first year was 2,000,005, sorry, in 2014 was 3,000,000 and reduced to become 2,540,000 in 2015, right? So you start with what is happening, what is the total conclusion. The total conclusion that we get from here, that the total quality cost for the recent year, which is 2015 here, 3,000,000, and the total quality cost is 2,540,000. This means reduced. This means the company implemented a quality improvement program. I would really like to see this sentence as an introductory for the comment on the quality cost report. So you just mentioned that the quality cost report for this year was this figure and reduced to become this figure, and this means the company implemented a quality improvement program. Okay? In this quality improvement program, the company invested more money in the control post or the control activities between practice prevention and appraisal to see some reduction into the failure costs, which are internal and external. Do you want me to read it again? And this is actually what happened. See the distribution here, of course the total of the distribution, the total is 100 for each year. But what happened in 2014, it's the company invested only 30.6 in the control, the prevention, and the appraisal, but they spend nearly 69 or nearly 70% on the failure, internal and external. But after implementing the quality improvement program, which investing more money or injecting more money into prevention and the appraisal, they can be investing the opposite way around, 70 in the control activities. And what happened here? Both internal and external failure decreased, become 30,000. And after you explain what happened in each category, and you might find it's really important to discuss or present what happened in each item, the conclusion is, if the company continue to invest in both prevention and appraisal, we would expect that the internal and the external failure reduced or eliminated to become zero. This is the conclusion I would really like to see. Because we start with that there is something wrong, that the company investing more money into the internal and the external failure, and then they investing more money or spending more money into prevention and appraisal, and they keep reducing the internal and the external failure. By the time goes, we would expect to see under internal and external failure is zero. This is why we are, in practice, we say for quality improvement program, it goes over between 3 and 5, or between 5 and 7 years. Of course, here, I'm presenting here only 2 years for just simplification. But in practice, it goes over 5 to 7 years. Any questions here? By the way, even if I finish with you here and you are not sure about anything, I will be around next week. So if you really need to arrange an appointment with me in the office or something, let me know and I have no problem with that. Okay? Discuss the difference between traditional and robust approaches. Where possible, support your answers with examples. I think we covered that. So the difference between traditional and robust and the example of NHS and the watch. Supporters of just-in-time argue that just-in-time is very relevant in balanced scorecard. I will tell you something here. Just give me 2 seconds.
McDonald's global success is fast, friendly service. A large component of this profitability by reducing costs yet increasing customer satisfaction.
Please write down that you have to watch this just in time in McDonald's along with balanced scorecard in McDonald's. Because even when you have a question on balanced scorecard or a question on just in time, it's really very easy because once you watch it, you will pick up the link between balanced scorecard and just in time. This was a video on just in time, how the process and how the manufacturing cell and how when the order started and all of this. I think we watched this video here, right? And then, criteria for success is service, quality, food preparation, people, profitability. And these criteria, these are the balanced scorecard dimensions, right? Because balanced scorecard dimensions are, can someone remind me, please? What are the balanced scorecard perspectives or dimensions? Employees, customers, internal processes, and financial. So these are the four main perspectives under balanced scorecard. And we added the environmental perspective as well. Because if you remember that this lecture when I asked you, okay, you are expert now in the environmental topic, where we are going to put the environmental perspective. Do you remember that? So all these, which is people, these are the employee, profitability, this is the financial, food preparation and the quality, and all of these are the internal processes. So by all means, there is a link between just-in-time and balanced scorecard. There is a link between just-in-time and the quality. There is a link between lean, again, lean is the kind of the roof that everything can be underneath that. The quality, the environmental, the just-in-time, everything. So even it doesn't matter for you to memorize the stuff. Once you understand what each one of them means, you will be able to figure it out. This is really what I really need to see you today. It's just to let you know that I really don't want you to memorize all the information because sometimes I keep receiving Management accounting, there is too much, too many topics. Can you just please tell us what we are going to study and stuff? Of course, I understand, I appreciate, I've been there the same as you years ago, but once you absorb the concept, you will be able just to get it. Okay? Section C. Section C is the theory question. I think last week we spent some time here in class about the external factor and expanding internationally, etc. Okay? So I said, if you find, read the questions very carefully, and if you decide to go to each one of them, I really, because this is a 30 mark essay question, which means, of course, we cannot deal with this type of question as a sub-question that was 4 marks or 5 marks, etc., right? So you have to organize your answer. You have to just provide introduction, content, and conclusion. So it might be the question in front of you is about external factors. You start by saying this case study or this question 4 or 5 is about the external factors that discussed by all these references that I've mentioned earlier on. DAFT et al. 2010, DAFT 2015, George 2011, and George 2018. And some people think, is it 2018? Yes, because I used the electronic version to prepare the whole book, and this is supposed to be 2018. So you are absolutely fine. So you start by provide academic definition of what the external factors are. The external factors that's already mentioned in the lecture of last week, or how to expand internationally. It doesn't really matter. Or if the question is general about, you know, kind of mention what or discuss what are the external factors or what are the factors that any company takes into consideration when they are expanding internationally, I would love to see examples as well. So you have, and again, I'm not asking you to read all the information that uploaded in Moodle, but at least to be aware of what kind of the factors affecting Microsoft versus Apple, or what are these related to Walmart, or even if you can talk about McDonald's or any company. It doesn't matter to be the one that I uploaded Moodle with, any company. But I would really like to see, because you will find that this sentence support your answers with questions and with examples and references where possible. So this is a question, if the question related to the external factor and expanding internationally. But I used to also just to have a question to say, supporters of eco-efficiency argue that environmental perspective should be reflected in balanced scorecard. That means when you started to read this question is out of 30 marks, but covering the two main topics, right? Eco-efficiency and balanced scorecard. So you start by saying, what does it mean eco-efficiency? The concept of eco-efficiency. And the concept of eco-efficiency, you will find a file titled eco-efficiency concept on Moodle under the environmental management accounting topic. What does it mean? So a concept, you have to provide a definition of eco-efficiency. You have to provide all the opportunities and the outcomes, and then provide me with an example. How on earth I'm getting it to get you example about eco-efficiency? Is your coursework. Your coursework or any company. If you are in a group and you know that, for example, you are working in an oil and gas industry, and one of the company that they have fantastic kind of way of disclosure about environmental activities, use it. I don't really mind if all of you using the same company, because this is not a coursework anymore. We just got done with the coursework, but we are just trying to link theory to practice. You know, this is the eco-efficiency concept, and this is how companies dealing with environmental activities, and here what happened in practice, right? And then you go to the balanced scorecard. What does it mean, balanced scorecard? I would really appreciate if you provide a definition of balanced scorecard to refer to the people who already invented balanced scorecard, which are Kaplan and Norton 1996. So when you provide a definition of balanced scorecard, you have to say that these are from Kaplan and Norton 1996. And then with the kind of argue with where you are going to put the eco, the environmental perspective on the balanced scorecard. Whether I think we spend some time here in class argue about that. Do you remember? Whether we have to create a fifth perspective on balanced scorecard, or leave the balanced scorecard with four perspective and name it eco balanced scorecard. Do you remember that? I would like to see this argument in the final exam script. And honestly, it doesn't really matter which one you are, you know, kind of go with, as long as you provide justification for that. So you think that environmental should be a fifth perspective because of 1, 2, 3, 4. Or you think that that balanced scorecard should be four perspectives only, and change the name to become equal balanced scorecard. And then provide example of balanced scorecard. I think we agreed about this before, that it's really up to you whether you prefer to get a proper example or using the same company as you have done in the coursework. I think there is Tesco, if anyone wants to have a wee look. Tesco balanced, it's called, I think, a wheel kind of balanced scorecard or card. There is Tesco, there is, I think, one of the oil and gas, BB, as far as I remember. Any company just to provide me with example on balanced scorecard. When you see, after you do that, I would really love to see this relationship and this diagram of the balanced scorecard that we covered in class to be explained as an evidence statement or a relationship related to the company. By the way, your core book has a fantastic example about one of the car industry. I think it's about Jaguar or BMW, as far as I remember. So have a wee look. Jaguar. Okay, so have a wee look and see, because they have mentioned that in a very, very simple way that you can absorb and understand. So it's really up to you whether you are going to get an example related to your using the same coursework company or any company, because under final exam situation, it doesn't really matter. Okay? And good luck and all the best for you. Any questions so far about anything? Any questions here? Everything is okay? Okay, good luck and all the best. Go for a break and then come back for the feedback session for the coursework.